Luke chapter number 22 verse number 69. It said that we see now that the Son of Man, that is Jesus, is seated at the right hand of the mighty God in heaven. Now if Jesus is seated at the right hand of the mighty God in heaven, how can he be God? Are you telling me that he's sitting? I called one day and said, it's Jesus. Jesus is sitting beside himself. I said, ridiculous. We are trying to reason with you. That's what the Quran said, Al-Imran 3, says, Kul yahal al-kitab. Say, oh, people the book. Say, oh, Jews and Christians. Ta'alaw ila kalimatin sawa'in bayna bayna'kum. That come to common terms as we do. As are you. Allah na'budu illa Allah. That we worship number Allah. Wa la nusuka bi shay'aw. That we associate no partners with him. Wa la yatik zabadun abadun al-baba midunillah. That we react not from among ourselves, lords or patron, other than Allah. Fa'inta Allah. But if they turn away, فَكُلُوا سَدُوا. Then they bear witness, they are now Muslimun, then we are Muslims bound to Allah's will. Simple. Jesus was the Messiah, sent to the kingdom of Israel. He said it, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. He never changed until he left this world. Never changed. So what is going on now? As I said, when Jesus left this world, the disciples were preaching for 30 years. They never said anything about Jesus being God. Never. Book of Acts, chapter number 5, verse number 42. Acts 5:42. Day after day, from temple to temple and from house to house, they never stopped preaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus was the Christ. Are you telling me that the children of Israel, the Christ they were waiting for, was God? I mean, you are mad. Because in your Bible, God said he's not a man. Hosea 11:9. God said it clear, emphatic, categorical. For I am God, I am not man. But you are telling me that Jesus is fully God and fully man. I'm asking you now, your Bible. Why is a single, show me a verse in the Bible which says that Jesus is fully God, fully man, he's not there. Show me a single verse from the Bible. Single verse. Where it says that the Father is eternal, the Son is eternal, and the Holy Ghost is eternal, not there. Show me a single verse in your Bible which says the God, that the Father is almighty, the Son is almighty, and the Holy Ghost is almighty. It's not there. Show me a single verse which says that the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Ghost is God. But there are not three gods, one God. Show me. It's not there. They can't show me here. But they will quote these verses. Because they've been brainwashed. You find this in the Athanasian Creed. The Creed is saying that. But in the Bible, no.
Mashallah.
You find only God the Father.
Mashallah.
God the Son. There is no a single verse which speaks about God the Son. There is no God the Son in the Bible. Or God the Holy Spirit.
Mashallah.
God the Father, yes. My brothers and sisters, I'm going to wrap it up. As I said, the Quran has got 114 surahs. From Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Nas. And if you want to know about the concept of God in Islam, you go to Surah Ikhlas. Surah Ikhlas is 112 surah. Oh, you say, Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say he is Allah the one. Allahu samad. Allah upon whom all depend. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And there is nothing unto like him. You see, and there is nothing unto like him. When he goes to the Bible, it's there. Then how can Jesus be God? When you go to Bible, Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 4. Lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad, and there is nothing unto like him. You go to your Bible, in the book of Exodus, chapter number 9, verse number 14. It says, God said, that you may know that there is none like me in all the earth. God says, there is none like me in all the earth. So if Jesus is a God, how can he be man? If Jesus is man, how can he be God? And God said there is nothing unto like him. He's not a man. My brothers and sisters, read your Bible with understanding. Several verses. Go to the Old Testament. You wrote the Old Testament. Let me quote a few more verses. You go to the Old Testament. Deuteronomy 6:4. Moses says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. The Lord our God is one Lord." Jesus said the same thing in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verse 29. The Lord our God is one Lord. The God our Lord, the God our Lord, the Lord is one. The Lord is one. This is simple, plain English. The Lord is one, not two, not three, not one and a half, not three in one, not one with a mystery attached to one, but only one. The Lord is one. The Bible, the only verse nearest to the concept of Trinity is in the first book of John, chapter number 5, verse number 7. We said, "For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one." But when you read here, the Revised Standard Version, the RSV, here, so the Revised Standard Version, 32 scholars of high, this is your Bible, 32 scholars of highest eminence, backed by 50 corporate denominations, wrote this book. They said, John, they said, begotten. These three are one, they chalk it out. First Epistle of John 5:7. "For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one," they took it out. They said they are not one. John 3:16, begotten, they chalk it out. They said it was not in the earliest manuscripts. So somebody is playing with the Word of God. Let me read what he said. Revised Standard Version, this is what it says about King James Version. Revised Standard Version, this is what it says about King James Version. It says, "Yet the King James Version has grave defects. By the middle of the 19th century, the development of biblical studies and the discovery of many manuscripts more ancient than those upon which the King James Version was based made it manifest that these defects are so many and so serious as to call for revision of the English translation. The task was undertaken by authority of the Church of England in 1870. My brothers and sisters, millions of people read this King James Version. They rely on that. But the Revised Standard Version said it has a great defect. And look at how many Bibles I've got. They are not the same. We have only one Quran, 114 surahs, 6,236 verses. No addition, no deletion, no contradiction. You can find it here. Today, if all the Qurans, if you burn them or they disappear, people will sit down and produce it from their head. Millions of people memorize the Quran in there. You cannot, there's no one in the world who has memorized these Bibles. No. And I say the Bible says, they are not the same, my brothers and sisters. Where is the original Bible? And it's full of additions and deletions and contradictions. Only one Quran. And it has been preserved. Allah said, in Surah Hijr, chapter number 15, verse number 9. Okay, say, "Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun." We have sent down the message, i.e. the Quran, and we will assuredly guard it from corruption. No corruption in the Quran. I come here, you have Hatun and Bob lying to people, or you have many different Qurans, so many verses. I tell them, bring them here. I come here with the Bibles. And I show you contradictions and additions and deletions. Bring those Qurans. We compare with this one, we see if there is more than one Quran. But they cannot. They only lie to people. Brothers and sisters, in humanity, they are deceiving you. The DCCI group, Hatun, Bob, and the rest are just deceivers. Furthermore, the Quran, I said the Quran is preserved. If you read the God's Quran, Allah said in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 82, it says that, that will they not then understand the Quran? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found that in many a contradiction. أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولا قرآن من إن غير الله لا وجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. Do they not reflect on the Quran? Do they not read and understand the Quran? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found therein many a contradiction. No contradiction, no addition, no deletion. As I said, 114 surahs. From Al-Fatiha to An-Nas, 6,236 verses. No addition, no deletion, unlike the Bible. So I'm going to end this. With a quotation from the Holy Quran, from Surah Al-Imran 364, say, "Kul yahal kitab," say, "O people of the book," say, "O Jews and Christians, ta'alu ila kalimatin sawa'in bayna wa baynakum," that come to common terms as and you, Allah na'budu illa Allah, that we worship none but Allah, wala nusyriku bihi shay'an, that we associate no partners with him, wala yattakhidhu ba'duna ba'dan arbaban min dunil lah, that we erect not from among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah, fa in tawallaw, but if they turn away, fa kulu sadu, then bear witness, we are now Muslimun, that we are Muslims bound to Allah's will. Wa akra da'wana walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.